name is Demosthenes Stamatis. I'm from Greece, representing the Technological Educational Institute. So here is what I want to talk. Of course, course aims and objectives, typically. Purpose of running the course, and as I will explain, in a pilot phase. I am saying from the beginning that our purpose is to develop this course in the context of the project, but there are, let's say, three steps. We have developed the material, we are running the course in a pilot phase, and then we are running the course in a smaller MOOC-like phase, and all these phases will give us the opportunity to improve it, I hope, and give it as a deliverable. I'm going to talk specifically about the target group we are aiming at. I hope some of you could be in this group. And other things, typical ones and not typical ones at the same time, duration of the course, and maybe the more important one, why is this course is different from others. There are thousands of interpretive courses. So objectives regarding knowledge, three entries. Of course, we expect our students to clear their mind regarding what interpretive is. We are aiming both to have the students work independently and in groups. And what is very crucial, that our students learn where they have to address themselves in order to learn, or in order to find information which is actually not available during the course period, and I will explain why. This is knowledge, but as you have seen through other presentations, we expect our students to acquire skills as well, and these skills are the tools and methodologies that they are going to use, and I'm not going to stay a lot here because you have different presentations for this. But concurrent design methodology is something we have worked 2 months in this project, and we glue the tools presented by Mariano earlier, which is the Osterwalder tools for preparing a model of yourself as an entrepreneur and a model for building up a business. So we expect students to have these skills by the end of the course. Competence. It is well known that most of the people, even very qualified people, are finishing with education, but they are not self-confident. They do not believe in themselves. So we hope we change the situation in a quick way. And of course, it's a competence issue. If you know how to collaborate with other people, and you don't believe that you're able to do everything by yourself. This is a fact that we very much take into account in this preparation of the course. Because people start companies, and maybe they don't know anything about how to form a company, but they think to it. Perhaps they are making mistakes. Perhaps they learn by their mistakes, so we take this into consideration and try to do it in the context of the course. Some things that perhaps are more interesting for the project members, but this will explain why perhaps you are not able to register for the first course, the first pilot course, and we advise you to, if you're interested, you or your friends or your students, register in the second triacquisite labs. We are actually running the course to test ourselves. So, we are running the course in order for the project team, the quality board we have formed, and some of the people are here, and students of the pilot phase will act as evaluators of content and activities of the course we are designing, just to have a better course in the second large pilot we are preparing. This is where you could enroll. Of course, normal human-computer interaction testing of what we have developed, is it good or not? Does it taste well? Apart from the objectives of content. And we have very carefully worked on CCD, presented earlier, trying to see how CCD glues with the situation. So it's not just a concurrent design methodology or a distributed concurrent design methodology. It's very much carefully transformed as a process specifically for offering an alternative course. This gave us the opportunity to develop the material, and now we are on its phase running a small pilot to go for the next one. What is our target group? Mainly information and communication technology students. That's what was initially written in the application. We are thinking perhaps of having business students as well, because this is a good amalgam of students, mostly final year students, but also graduates and postgraduate students, and especially motivated students. This is not a course, as many others, saying you are not an entrepreneur type of person. We will turn you to that type of person. But we believe that we attract people that already are motivated to start a business. And they are also people not willing or not having enough time to follow a three-year course on a university, or even to follow a bigger seminar. So they are motivated and they don't have time. We are aiming at this group of people, and it's not rare to meet these two occasions. Okay? Of course, the target group for the pilot is very small. As I said earlier, it's for test purposes. So we have about 15 learners, and we didn't follow a democratic procedure of selecting them, as we have discussed quite a bit. But we picked up the right people which will help us with evaluation. This might be a problem, but as I described, the pilot phase is still a phase that we develop, of course. Okay. Cross-sectoral, cross-cultural, intercultural groups, because we are nice flags over there representing all the partners. So we are really testing different cultures for our different types of students. Greeks and Portuguese arriving a little bit late in classes, with Danish students coming five minutes earlier than the course starts, and UK that they are arriving exactly on time. Okay, we try to see how this amalgam works again, because we are working at the European level. Okay, and different styles and culture are important to take into consideration. I will give you 5 minutes to read this letter. It's an example of motivated student. He knows what he has done. He wants to do business. He wants to count on special skills he already has, and he's looking for people internationally to start a small business. He admits that he doesn't have any knowledge of how to run a business, and this is why he loved our courses. Okay. This is what I said earlier. We have developed a course for different types of students, but mainly for motivated students. And I will explain more why. This is a map with the partners. And we are mentioned here since we are responsible for firing up the pilot course. So this is really a very intensive course. You should spend only 8 weeks of workload time and at least 50 hours of involvement with all the material, with all group interaction, with all student to teacher interaction, which from the first time sounds crazy. People that have worked with internship courses end up with a master's degree, which means modules and modules, etc. So we are not the kind of stupids. We know that we cannot offer such a big course, and we are trying to see what are the key elements that we can trigger so that the students could get advantage of this situation. Since the start of the courses, November 5th, there will be an intervention of the students. We have even choose this to give them a little bit time to talk with us about evaluation and think about what they are doing so that they are really on a pilot. Anna, our famous Anna in the project said a lot about e-learning, and as you understand from, or perhaps you understand, we are aiming at amalgamation of different techniques. We are aiming, you know the word amalgamation?
Yes.
A mixture of styles, technologies, theories. So we consider a blended type of learning offered through this course. Of course, e-learning, since we are not face to face. We say to our students from the beginning that you are here to start a business. You're not here to learn what entrepreneurship is, and only what innovation is. That's easy because we have recorded Lacan's presentation. But very early, we give them the information they need about the distributed concurrent design process and the tools they are going to use, and let's say from the real beginning start your business with this. And we are aiming at a successive refinement during course time, that, as Mariano said, they put something into canvases having to do with all the issues regarding they aim to build the company, and with successive refinements, reading the material and following the activities of the course, we come back to redesign what we expect to become a business model, which will be the basis for a business plan that they should present to us. Still, we are aiming at an amalgamation. I mean, we are talking about self-directed learning, which seems to be opposite to group learning. But we put all these together. We expect students, the latest, after 3 weeks, that they have formed a group, and they are discussing an innovative or just an idea which will be used to, as a basis to start a company. And this is what makes students be curious about learning content and activities we propose. We have prepared material for 8 modules. Initially we say this could be 8 weeks, but students are not forced to follow a week by week path, because together with the content there is a specific description of activities that they should do, starting from the idea and ending to the business plan. So they have 2 paths: either go as group students and study group by group, or follow the timeline of activities which triggers them to go to the material. The material is carefully designed and is a first suggestion, but there is other reference material for those in the group. And we are asking our students to split things between each other in order to be quick. And as you remember, in the concurrent design methodology, there are 3 points in the triangle: it's people, it's processes, okay? And this should come in a balance. You should take care of all these. So people coming perhaps with different ideas at the beginning, having different knowledge about what is the process of building a company. Together with the material they have, together with the activity list they have, they try to collaborate or work alone in order to bring these pieces together, which for the group we expect, as presented earlier, in the pilot 2 or 3 groups, but later on many groups, to bring all these things together in a successful way.
I've come back again. Thank you back, Penny. This is just to say that Demos has told you in considerable detail how we propose to pilot. And really the point is that the first pilot is a small group of students who we're bringing through, really to test the process, the procedures, the mechanisms that we've put in place, and see how it all hangs together to make sure that what we have is a course that we can be reasonably happy with, and we can change for things that don't work. What we then want to do is to say, okay, we want to go open, we want to have a bigger experience in which we really test this with live, willing people. Particularly, we want people from industry who are working in the field and are interested in developing their entrepreneurial knowledge, right? Obviously students, but anybody who is interested. Anne talked about MOOCs and the move from MOOCs to, what was the one you were using, Anne?
Spox,
yes. Well, just to add to the list, there's also DOCS, Distributed Open Collaborative Courses, POOCs, Participate Open Online Courses, BOOCs, Boutique Open Online Courses, various others, and SLAPS and SLAPS. I don't care. It does not put me up or down what it is we decide we're going to call it. What it will be is that we're going to have an open model where people will be given the opportunity to register and join for the course. The course will run for the same period, probably from about the 1st of March. So it'll be running over an 8-week period, and it'll be 50 hours of effort, student effort, during that period. Now, when we say 50 hours of effort, I'll be honest, what we're saying is, we believe that what we've designed you can get through in 50 hours. My experience of people doing these things is the amount of time they commit varies according to the love they feel for the process and how inspired they become. But we certainly believe that 50 hours will be a manageable element of time within that. And how we will organise this is that we will be putting people, as we've identified, into groups. Nominally, the groups will be between 4 and 8 people. There will be a process of idea generation and group self-selection. And we will have a lot of students. We hope to have thousands. Right? That just so we're clear as far as that's concerned. And we will have a structured model by which you will get information, assessment, and so forth. So I would encourage all of you, if you are interested in this, right, the information will be available through SINFIN and through the FLIGHT website. And as I say, we'll be aiming to run this around about the 1st of March. Do get involved and take part. It will be good. That was all I wanted to say.